chapter 20. Look at your neighbor, say neighbor. I need an 11th hour intervention for me to end my year on a sweet note. Matthew chapter 20. Oh, look, when it comes to the last thing like this, things does not work the way you think. Because when it comes to 11th hour, you cannot decide by yourself. If you can decide by yourself, you will have programmed it by yourself. But it's a thing left for God and God alone. 11th hour is a dying minute. It's the last minute of everything. When you see two teams playing on the field and they play draw, there was no testimony this side, there was no testimony that side. They will have extra minutes, like 15 minutes. Then in that 15 minutes is called dying minute. Anybody who score in the dying minute has won. No matter how you try. If I score you in the dying minute and you are trying to dribble me, both leg and ball, I'll be clearing them. Am I correct? I will not even allow the ball to reach my side. If I don't see where they'll play it to outside, everything bah, outside. Where you throw tire. And you know when they say throw it, go and bring ball, they don't pause the clock. That is the trick. But the God of this last minute, if he has kept you to this dying minute, he has a reason for that. He has a purpose for you. And that purpose must be fulfilled in the name of Jesus. Matthew chapter 20 verse 6. I'm talking about 11th hour intervention. Many people, many Christians need it now. It is now you need it. 11th hour for God to intervene, to step into your case, to consider your own. In the book of Matthew chapter 20 verse 6, let's hear this. He said, and about the 11th hour, Jesus went out. Hallelujah. About the 11th hour, he went out to still look for who to bless. Today, Jesus is in the house seeking for who to bless. I said today Jesus is in the house. At the about 11th hour, he went out looking for the remaining people, looking for those who are yet to testify, looking for those who are still waiting and crying, looking for those who are still weeping all day long. At about 11th hour. Is there anything of your life that is yet to be fulfilled? At about 11th hour. It did not stop that time has elapsed. Before God, time has not elapsed. For he himself is time. It does not work by any time. And at about 11th hour, he went out. Oh, he met some people standing. They never believe anything will happen. They have given up. The day is dark. The year has ended. The year has expired. Some people did not believe now that they can see husband again. They are putting their hope in 2020. But listen to me. If only you have faith, nothing shall be impossible. At about this 11th hour, the right man can come your way. And it'll be so serious, very serious. At about this 11th hour, some people are going to do introduction. Some people are going to do engagement. Some people are going to do marriage. The one that married yesterday was about 11th hour. It looks as if it will not happen. Every of your expectation that looks as if the year has swallowed, the year will vomit it before the year expires. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. If you believe it, rise up and shout a very amen to the King of Glory. Tell your neighbor, at about 11th hour, the scripture says, at about the last minute, at about the end of the day, at about the expiration of the year, Jesus decided to go out. And I see him walking around, looking at everyone. And the Bible says, and found others. Others having blessed the rest, having called the rest and given them purpose in life. He called the rest and told them, go and walk in my vineyard. He gave them a purpose to live. He gave them a reason to be alive. He gave them a reason. When he hired them to walk in his vineyard, that means he gave them a focus. He gave them a dream. He gave them a vision. And he gave them the opportunity, earth and life, to actualize it. But at about 11th hour, some people, their life was still purposeless. At about 11th hour, some people, they have no bearing. Know where they are going, anywhere, sir. At about 11th hour, they have no testimony to share. They are expecting nothing. They live for nothing. The Bible said they were standing what? Idle. Idle means lust of opportunity. Idle means there was no source of living. Are you hearing me? Maybe you find yourself in such a condition. At this 11th hour of the year, Jesus will step into your case in the name of Jesus. Your amen is not sounding as I expected. Now, the scripture says, when he went out at 11th hour, he was in search of others. Listen, brothers and sisters, he has started employing and giving people direction of life from morning. And it was almost the end to close to reward them. And at that 11th hour, in his wisdom, he decided to go in search of somebody like you. For the fact that you have not shared testimony since January this year does not mean that you end your year like this. Hey, hear me. Your testimony will arrive now. I say your testimony will arrive now. I'm talking to somebody here today. If you can hear me, I say your testimony is now. Your testimony is better occur now. It will appear now. It will manifest now. If you are the one, rush out and shout a better amen to the King of Glory. I didn't say stand up. I said rush out. Rush like rush. It's like you don't know the meaning of rush. Oh, yes. He said they were standing idle. Now, I began to look at that scripture. I began to pray. And the Bible and the Holy Spirit began to interpret to me the meaning of standing idle. And the word of God said in the book of Ephesians chapter 6, verse 13. Now, who are the people who are standing? Ephesians chapter 6 verse 13. And he said, he was talking about, from verse 11, was talking about, we wrestle not flesh and blood, but against principalities and power, against rulers of darkness of this world, and against spiritual hosts of wickedness. And he said, wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of God. People who are standing are those who have fulfilled every righteousness. He said, they wear the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to withstand in the evil day. And having done all, having wear the whole armor of God, they do what? Stand. People who are standing are people who have kept themselves. They did not soil their hand. They did
did not do anything wrong. They never bowed their knees for Baal. They never bowed their head. Though they see no testimony, though they have no purpose for living, though they have no reason to be joyful, but yet they are risen and their hope is in God. They are the type that wake up in the morning and they decided, I will not soil my testimony. I will not soil my garment of praise. I will not allow any stain upon my garment. I will keep myself no matter the case, no matter how the case look like. I will keep standing for my God. I will stand on the truth. I will stand by the truth. I will stand for the truth. And those people were still standing, yet they were hiding. They have nothing to play with. Oh, standing on the promises that cannot fail, holding on to the angels speak glory in the highest. I will shout and sing, standing on the promises of God. Even the hymn explained those who are standing for you, that you believe God promised me I cannot die alone, I will get married. God promised me I will not be poor, and you are still standing on that promise. I say, standing, I am standing on the promises of God. Oh my God, say that. How many promises and prophecy have you had that you are still holding on to, and yet they are nowhere to be found, but you still stand? You were told you cannot be poor, but here you are, you cannot even foot your primary bills, but you are still standing. God have a reason for keeping you till now. At this 11th hour, you were standing before, but now you will start dancing. I say now you will start dancing. I say now you will start dancing. I say now you will start dancing. In the mighty name of Jesus, dancing will be your portion. Oh, those who are standing and those who are putting on the old armor of God. Some of you, now we are talking about 11th hour, the God of 11th hour. It does not come for those who are not standing. It doesn't come for those who are falling by the wayside. It does not come for those who does not know their right from their left. It doesn't come for those who put one leg high, Bible in hand, Satan in mind. You may be thinking no one is seeing you. If I'm not in your church, then I'm not your brother. The Bible says, love your neighbor as yourself. When we are in trouble, we remember God. In the times of enjoyment, to hell we live. Whether we like it or not, that day we come. When we give account of our stay here or there. We preach in churches, marketplaces, and gospel. That men should repent, for the judgment is at hand. But back in our home, we gossip, quarrel, and bye-bye. No matter your position, we shall all face the truth. When we are in trouble, we remember God. In times of enjoyment, to help me. Whether we like it or not, that day will come. When we give account of our stay here or there. Bible in hand, Satan in mind. You may be thinking, no one is seeing you. If I'm not in your church, then I'm not your brother. The Bible says, love your neighbor as yourself. I say, we are each other, we remember God. In times of enjoyment, to love you. Whether we like it or not, that day will come. When we give our time, of our stay here or not. We do shady business, taking cover in some. You may be thinking, nobody see you. Donation to church cannot cleanse our sin. The Bible says, love your neighbor as yourself.
When we are in trouble, we remember God. In times of enjoyment, to help me. Whether we like it or not, that day will come. We will give account of our stay here or there.
Somebody shout, God of 11th hour. Sit down. Are you standing? Are you still standing? Despite the mockery of men, as people mock you before, have they laughed at you before? In your family, have they discussed you behind you that you amount to nothing? When everybody has given up on you, when all your hope are gone, when you are at your wit end, that is your 11th hour. When even all your junior to the last one has married, and they are coming to meet you, sister, any man, when you wear spaghetti, nobody see you. You wear macaroni, nobody see you. You wear body hug, nobody see you. You wear body marry, nobody see you. You wear body kiss, nobody see you. When you put perfume and you think it will attract people, and you are smelling full hair. When you are at your wit end, it's your 11th hour. When you have even given up that the thing will never happen again, that you have resigned to faith that maybe this is how God created me, I have good news for you. Before 2019 expire, that thing that you have decided maybe that is how God wants him, God go change him. I said this God of 11th hour go change him for you. He go change him for you. Rise up and shout amen like a true child of God. Kai Malibra Andesku Praya Zindeko Likata Ikas Kaida Kato Limbra Indegede. Maybe they have feel that is this 3 circles you will write to end here. The God of 11th hour see your heart. He know those who are standing. Are you still standing? Those who stand are those who put on the whole armor of God. Those even in the time of evil, when they are ashamed, but they are not ashamed of the gospel of Christ. St. Paul say in the book of Romans chapter 1 verse 16, say, for I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ. For it is the power of God unto salvation, to the Jew first and unto the Gentiles. Those, even though when there is shame written all over, but they are not ashamed of Christ. Those who still stand and speak about their God, even why people will say, look at your life. Is this how your God can treat human beings? Those who does not allow their condition to be written all over their head and bring it to church. Those who does not sit down at home and expect everybody's visitation. They are those who are standing. Those who are not looking for pity from men. Listen to me. Men cannot pity you. Men can only sympathize with you. If you seek for pity, believe you me, the same your mother that I've been telling you, don't worry, God go do them. One day we open our mouth and look at you and say, your mate don't marry, finish, you sit down here, they eat my food. Go and help yourself. No man can pity you. What man can do for you is to sympathize with you. But believe you me, there is a God that is called the God of 11th hour. And he brings 11th hour miracle. He creates 11th hour testimony. Hallelujah. Listen to me. Are you standing? That is the issue. The issue is not that God will not intervene. And how he will intervene is not known to me. It's not known to you. But the problem is, are you standing? They were standing, though they were hiding. But thank God they
stood at a strategic place. Thank God they stood where Jesus can reach up to them. But as you are here, haven't you compromised? Didn't you go to a river to wash your head? Didn't you put incision on your body? Didn't you do one thing or the other with an idol or with an altar? Haven't you gone to call the name of a man that you wish to marry on the evil altar? Haven't they tied you and the man together in the soul? And you are saying, oh, the man, this 11th hour, the man must answer me. It's not man that answer you for 11th hour, it is God. Don't think your case has been delayed. Don't think that you have given up, that there is no more any other time. Don't put your hope again in 2020, just like you did in 2018. That you put hope on 2019. Anything that is your right in 2019, you must get it. This year will not expire without giving you all your properties. I said this year will not expire without you getting blessed. Without you getting blessed, it will not pass away until you are blessed in the name of Jesus. If that prophecy resembles your destiny, rise up and do something for Jesus. At about 11th hour. But the issue is, when they were standing at the right place. That is, they were standing at the right place and Jesus was able to walk up to them. I don't know whether the Spirit of God is giving you the interpretation. Although they were standing in the right place and yet in their life they were idle. They lack opportunity. They lack manifestation. They lack opportunity to manifest. There was no room for them. But yet he met them and he came and gave them direction. Go to my vineyard. After this service, the Lord God will minister to you and you will know the right business to put your money. The God of 11th hour. The issue is, are you standing? Check yourself. Ask your neighbor, have you been standing? Or you are waving? Stand up and ask three people, have you been standing or you were shaking all this while? Wait for an answer. Hallelujah. Listen to this. Before I round up, I'm just introducing this program. And God will see you at the very point of your needs. But tell your neighbor, keep standing. Tell another neighbor, keep holding on. Oh, keep holding on. I say, keep holding on. Hey, keep holding on. I say, keep holding on. I never, never give up. I follow you to the end. I wait until I receive. I stand until I have it. Yeah, I never, never give up. I follow into the end. I pray until I receive. I stand until I have it. Yeah, I never. Never give up. I follow him to the end. I pray until I receive. I say I stand until I have it. Holding on, keep holding on. Keep holding on. Holding on, keep. Keep holding on. I never, never give up.
until the end.
I pray until I receive. I stand until I have it. Never and never, never give up. I follow it to the end. I pray until I
receive.
I stand until I
have it.
Are you standing? Are you sure you are standing?
Yes,
or you have given up already? Ask your neighbor, say brother. If the person is a brother, say brother.
Yes,
if the person is a sister, say sister. Keep standing.
Yes,
no shaking. Tell them no shaking. Keep standing. No shaking. Don't shake. Oh. Listen to me. In the book of Daniel chapter 6, the Bible was talking about Daniel, and they took Daniel, and they were about to throw Daniel into lion's den. Listen to me. Daniel was a prayer warrior. Daniel was a prayerful man. The Bible says when they said, everybody in the city at the sound of the trumpet, bow your head for an idol. And Daniel said no. Daniel opened his windows. He opened all his door. And he bowed his head to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Why? He knows that death is the sentence. Are you still standing? All you are doubting, all you are wavering, all you are shaking. You are afraid your husband will go and impregnate somebody because you have not given to birth. That means that you are not standing. When you are standing, you fear nothing. All your hope, oh my hope, is built on nothingness than Jesus' blood and righteousness. How can I fear the sweetest frame? Bet holily on Jesus' name. On Christ the solid rock I stand. All of the ground is sinking sand. All of the ground is sinking sand.
Hear what God say about you. He said, I will be with you in time of pain. Why would they harm you? Because you are mine. I'll fight your battle and give you my victory. I will be with you. I will be with you. That's who I am. He said, I will be with you.